Hello, everybody. It's numerologist Michelle Buchanan with your numerology forecast for December 2018. Can you believe it's almost the end of the year? And what a crazy year it's been. Some people have had an amazing year, where the rest of us have had a pretty hard time. Not gonna lie, 2018 was always meant to ruffle some feathers. But don't you worry, because I'm here to help you. I'm gonna hold your hand the rest of the way through and give you some guidance that can help you to make the remaining days of the year the best they can possibly be. So let's begin by calculating your personal year number. We do this by adding the day and month of your birth date to number two. All right, the day and month or month and day of your birth date to number two. So let me use the example April 4th. We would go 4 plus 4 plus 2. All right, now that actually adds up to 10. And the rule of thumb here is to continue to add together any double digit numbers until you get a single number between 1 and 9. So in my example, 4th of April, 4 plus 4 plus 2 equals 10, we then go 1 plus 0 equals 1, and that would be a 1 personal year. Okay, so let's begin with the forecast, starting with personal year number 1. Alright, so those in a 1 year, this whole year, life is encouraging you to create a fresh start, a new beginning, all right? And some of you, it's really obvious. There may have been a new job, a new relationship, a new hobby, a new project, you know, and it's really obvious in your physical world. Others, not so much. Everything's still the same, but what's being required of you and asked of you is that you create a new mindset, a new way of perceiving yourself and your life. And this is the case for everyone in a 1 year. It's about life is asking you to perceive through different eyes so that you can look at the way that your life has unfolded. You can look at yourself, you can look at your life through different eyes. And that means about reaching a higher level of understanding and awareness and perception. We need to realize, guys, that we did not come here to be the perfect person with the perfect life. We came here to learn, grow, and evolve through the life experiences we have while we're here. And we grow the most through our challenges. And that's why we will, all of us, always have challenges. We were never meant to have an easy ride, okay? Now, we need to, especially if you're in a 1 year, you need to perceive yourself through those eyes. You know, everything that's happened to me is not because I'm being punished. It's not because life is a conspiracy against me. It's because I can learn from this and I can grow and I can become a better person than I was as a result. And so that's the mindset you need to take moving forward. Now, one is a very creative vibration, a very a powerful manifestation number. So you need to know that it all comes down to how you think, how you perceive things as to what you'll attract back. And life is giving you an opportunity to have a clean slate now, to perceive through different eyes, to have a more positive, optimistic mindset so that you can start attracting more favorable circumstances and well-being and abundance and better health in your life. You are in the driver's seat. You need to take charge, but only you can control what thoughts you put in that mind of yours. Now, for the month of December, no slowing down. Yes, it's the Christmas season for those that celebrate Christmas, and there'll be a lot of, you know, opportunities to rest and relax, but for the most part, you are going to be busy. And that can mean busy with things on your plate regarding workload, can be physical work at your job, work at home, things that need doing. It's going to be a lot on your plate, and you need to know that you need to be patient. You need to persevere. You need to know there are going to be obstacles and challenges, but you've got what it takes to get through. Head down, bum up, positive mindset once again. Know that this can be a very fulfilling month at the end of it, or a fulfilling year by the time you get to the end of it with the right attitude. It all comes down to attitude. When the going gets tough, the tough must get going. Put your head down, your bum up, put the effort in, and the rewards will be there to show for it. Okay, personal year number two. Now, this year, number two year has been accelerating and amplifying your emotions. So whatever you've been feeling, if you've been feeling down or sort of victimized and powerless and depressed and down, then that number two energy is going to make you feel a lot more down. So you need to know that you, it's not you, it is you, but it's amplifying whatever you're projecting out. And that's why you need to get clear about what you're projecting out and what you're thinking and feeling so that you can take charge and sway it in the other direction. On the other flip side of that, on the advantage of that side, it's saying that whatever, if you're feeling good, you can really amplify that good feeling also. And that's where we attract from whatever we feel anyway. But why not attract things you'd rather have in your life? Solutions to problems, opportunities, you know, healthy relationships, enjoyable work experiences, instead of the opposite. And so the 2 year is asking you to realize what you feel and why you feel it and changing your perspective on that. Now also you need to know that the 2 is showing you how to have balance. It's helping you to understand by accelerating your emotions what takes you out of balance, where you lose your power. Do you let your worries get the better of you and the next thing you're out of balance and you're off center and you're all over the show? You know, that's what life is trying to ask you to understand, where you lose your balance, what causes you to get your speed wobbles, you know, and to make adjustments so that you can avoid those situations. Now, for the month of December, it's a month of change, progress, movement, and change, because this has been a pretty heavy, slow going year, but things are going to speed up in December. You may find there'll be a lot of things going on. You have your finger in a lot of different pies. So sort of be adaptable, flexible. Things are going to come from left field. It is a vibration of change. So especially if there are relationship issues that have been brewing beneath the surface, things can come from left field, you know, opportunities to repair things or change something where there's going to be a change and there's nothing we can do about it and we just have to roll with it. Trust life. Trust yourself. Believe that you'll be okay no matter what happens, that you will land on your feet. But for the most part, you want to look at your life this month and say, what changes need to be made within myself, within my life, so that I can feel more happier? Make those changes, take action, but be patient, because again, it's a slow energy with the 2 year, but the 5 month speed things up, and you are in a 5 month. And so remember, your main thing this month is, what changes do I need to make in my life, and take the steps to make them and be optimistic. Personal year number 3, this has been a year where once again your emotions are being amplified. So if you've been feeling good and on top of the world, you're going to feel like really, really good. Like the world's in the palm of your hands, you're on fire, you feel a bit more charismatic, you've got a bit more kick in your step, that kind of thing. And on the other hand, if you've been feeling down, if you've been buying into drama, then that's going to accelerate that as well. And you need to know that, okay? And so you're in a very creative vibration with this combination of numbers that you're in. And so this is definitely a time where, with regarding to the relationships in your life, especially through the month of December, because you're in a 6 month with that 3 year, it's about communication, saying what needs to be said, getting things off your chest, expressing yourself. And that expression can be in conversations with people, or it can be just expressing the sadness or the anger or the emotions you feel about whatever you're feeling that is holding you back or has makes you feel out of sorts or unhappy. You've got to express those emotions out. Now, you can do it many different ways. Some people do it through exercise. Some people do, you can sing to some songs that represent, you know, in the shower, in your car, when no one else is around, that express what you're going through. You can write, you can journal, you've got to get it out, okay? Better out than in, because when emotions, is a negative emotion that's trapped inside, that festers, all right, that's unexpressed, it festers and it eventually creates disharmony in the physical body and disharmony in the experiences in your life. And that's why you've got to express and get it out. So that's very, very important for you. You also need to understand what makes you happy. You know, what makes you happy, and do more of what makes you happy, because when you feel good, you're from a much better standpoint to attract solutions to problems and better opportunities coming into your life. So you need to, you know, keep yourself feeling good as best you can. For the month of December, this is a time where you need to be a shoulder to cry on. Be there for those who need you, even if it's a bit of an inconvenience. Know that the universe understands it's a convenience for you. You have to do the right thing when you're called to be of service. Know that the universe will compensate you at the other end eventually, but you do need to be there when you are needed and think of others. Be more cooperative, be more understanding, especially when it comes to resolving conflicts with other people. That could be family members, children, neighbors, friends, whatever, just people in general, clients, misunderstandings, you know, ironing these things out, having your say, and finding balance within yourself so you're not, you know, getting the short end of the stick, but at the same time having your say, but being open to resolving things. So being more cooperative, more understanding, more caring, seeing things from other people's point of view. Okay, personal year number four. You know, this year has been hard going. There's been a lot of effort required from you, and that can be effort and physical work, a lot on your plate, a lot physically, a lot of things to be done, a lot of action needed to be taken, and it's slow going. You know, this year has required you to be patient. It can be quite challenging because things may not unfold or happen as quickly and easily as you would like them to, or as much as easy and quickly as they have in the past, and so you've really needed to persevere, and you need to keep that up for the rest of the year. When the going gets tough, the tough must get going. You need to know that you can make it through. No matter what comes your way, you can do it. It's all up here. And I know it's hard. I know it's hard. Trust me, I know it's hard. And so that's why even more so is our mindset so important during these times. You know, patience, perseverance, determination. You are being tested in your commitment and your dedication and in your ability to be optimistic and to believe that you will find a way, that things will work out. All right. And for the month of December, it's like you've had a lot of learning this year. You've had a lot of challenges to go through, a lot of things going on. And December is really giving you a chance that you need to create some space, some quiet time alone so that you can evaluate everything you've gone through, so that the penny can drop, so that you can have those aha moments where everything starts to fall into place and you can say, well, I see why that happened now. I understand why I needed to go through that. I understand why it needed to happen that way so that it could happen, so that I could go and learn and go and attract from that point of view. The more you know, the more you perceive what's going on in the correct from a higher perspective, you raise your vibration. The higher level of awareness you reach, the higher your vibration. The higher your vibration, the more in touch you are with life itself, the more in synchronicity you are, the more you're in the right place at the right time. All of that kind of stuff. Meditation, time in nature, quiet time alone, yoga, breathing, breath work, visualization. All these things are going to help you. And December is asking you to make some space and create some time to do that. This is also a good month to study, to learn, and to ask the big questions. Who am I? Where am I going? What's the meaning of life? What makes me happy? What makes me unhappy? And what steps do I need to take to eliminate those things and improve my life? Big questions going inwards this month for you. Personal year number five, wow, what an action-packed year it's been. And it's not going to slow down either. It's going to carry that way through right to the end of the year. The 5 year has been about progress, movement, and change. You would have had your finger in a lot of different pies. There'd be things coming. You needed to be adaptable and flexible because things might come that you didn't see coming. And they can be exciting, amazing things and opportunities and experiences. And they can be things that aren't so happy and exciting, challenges that you didn't foresee that have changed your life completely and changed the path that you're on. And again, once again, it's to know that you can use this to your advantage. You will be okay. Roll with the punches. Life knows what it's doing. Trust and have faith that things are happening behind the scenes and that you will fall on your feet. Now you want to take advantage of this energy, especially for the month of December, because you are in an 8 month for December, and that is a very powerful law of attraction manifestation number. So you need to pay attention to what you're thinking about. You need to make sure that you're not thinking about and worrying about things you don't want to happen, that you're not dwelling on the past, because that's only holding you back. You want to give your attention to how you'd rather things be and what you want to have happen, and give attention to that, especially in the month of December. Try for things you normally wouldn't try for. Be more adventurous. Try some new things. Ask for things you normally wouldn't ask for. You can only be told no. That's okay. You can live with that, but you don't know unless you ask. You know that this is a very dynamic number, combination of numbers, and to get in touch with the law of attraction, understand the intricate details of it. Basically, the rule of thumb is, if you want something, then you want to believe it's possible and you want to imagine it. Creative visualization is just daydreaming, imagining, fantasizing how you would like things to be in your mind. And the universe can't tell the difference between what is an imagined thought, what is a memory of something amazing that happened in the past that you'd like to attract again, or whether it's just a dream. It can't tell what's real and what's not. All the universe and the subconscious mind do is they just get a repetitive vision or a repetitive emotion or a repetitive thought or a vision or a dream, and they get it so much because it's a numbers game here. It's like, you know, the more you believe in something, the more energy you give it, the more that you will attract it. It's like a numbers game. It just gets, if the universe gets a repetitive order, then eventually it just goes, I'm just going to manifest it, send it back in physical form. So that's how it works. And know that and take advantage of that energy. It's a very, very powerful time. Try not to overspend and budget your finances. Personal year number 6. Well, this year has been a lot has maybe been required of you in terms of being there for those who need you. That will continue on for the rest of the year. All right, relationship issues that have been brewing beneath the surface will rise to be resolved so that you can have the conversations that need to be had, so that you can both reach a mutual understanding. Now, some relationships and connections with people will improve because of this, and some will drop away. Don't be afraid when this happens, especially through the month of December. You're in the month of December is a month of endings, completion, and transformation. So I want you to look at yourself, look at your life, look at those around you, and think, what have I outgrown? Who have I outgrown? What situations do I want to clear away from moving forward? To know that, yes, you're there for those who need you. You're there to be the shoulder to cry on, to be of service to others. But at the same time, you also need to know what situations are good in your life and what aren't, and take steps towards making those changes. And that's also to do with your own self and your own personal health and well-being. What bad habits have you got health-wise? Now is the time to look at those things. We're creating a new you this month. We're letting go of things that you sort of want to work through. It may be personal development. It may be personality issues or limiting beliefs or fears or worries or things you've been carrying around that you don't want to carry around with you moving forward from 2019 onwards. So take a look at those and do some evaluating in the month of December. Personal year number 7. Okay, so we're coming to the end of the year. It's been a very slow going year. You know, you may have been trying to push for things to happen in your life and they may not be unfolding as quickly and as easily as you would like. It's been a lot of work that's supposed to have gone down this year behind the scenes within your own personality. This is a year, and that's still continuing on for another month, where you are being asked, who am I? To ask yourself the big questions. Who am I? What's the meaning of life? Get in touch with what you believe spiritually. Be open to understanding the secrets and mysteries of the universe, towards developing yourself, expanding yourself, advancing within yourself with knowledge and wisdom and understanding, reaching a higher level of awareness and understanding beneath the surface of your everyday life. For the month of December, we're looking at some new beginnings and new opportunities. You're going to get a fresh dose of energy here now. You know, you're going to feel a lot more energized. Things will start speeding up. There are going to be opportunities for you to create new things. So take a look at that. What do you want to create? And you've got to be proactive. So this is a green light energy. Move forward. Take steps that need to be taken to get things set up for yourself. Be proactive. Don't say, I need to do this, I want to do this, and do nothing. Not good. Take advantage of this energy. It is a green light energy. But at the same time, meditation, time in nature, quiet time alone to contemplate and have those aha moments, and to process everything that you've learned this year, everything that's happened to you, to sit back and to be able to say to yourself, I see why that unfolded that way now. I can see why I attracted that. I can see why that, as awful as it was, I needed to have it happen so that I could get where I am now. You know, to have that higher level of understanding and awareness. And that's what this year has all been about. Okay, so make make sure that you take action and create those new beginnings and new opportunities this month. Personal year number 8. Okay, so for some people there'd be a strong focus on career, finances, money, those sorts of things. Others, not so much. Others just are going through some major life lessons, some major experiences that may have happened to you this year that cause you to reach a higher level of awareness, to have grown as a human being, and to be able to sort of put your big girl or big boy pants on and face some, make some big decisions. And that energy isn't going anywhere. We are in a 11-2 month for you for December. And that's where now for 8 is a very powerful law of attraction number, like I've said in the forecast throughout this whole year for you guys. You need to know that we are creative beings. And one of the reasons that we're all on earth in the first place as human beings is to learn how to manage that creative power that we have, to know that we're creative, to know that our thoughts are alive. You know, no thought is wasted. You know, and it's creating. We're creating things based on what we think and believe and what we project down on a daily basis. And the 11-2 month that you're in for December brings emotion into it. So whenever we have a thought or a fear or a something that we're trying to attract and we bring emotion into it, it amplifies. So therefore, you need to be doubly aware this month of what you worry about, what you fear, you know, and get on top of that. Know that those fears don't necessarily need to happen, but to know that just by giving them your attention, you're inviting them into your experience, you're inviting them into your life. Great energy to get closer to people, great energy to, you want to follow your intuition this month, you're going to be more heightened awareness with emotion and sensitivity. So trust your gut instincts. Okay, express what you want to say, what you want to feel. Issues that have been brewing beneath the surface with people will come up to be resolved. Be cooperative, be understanding, see the other person's point of view. And more importantly, well, most important, be kind and loving to yourself. Okay, I want you to treat yourself like you would treat your best friend. None of this negative, nasty talk and giving yourself a hard time. Treat yourself like you would treat a friend. Be kind and gentle and nurturing to yourself. All the time, not just this month. And last but by no means least, we have personal year number 9. And you know, this is a great way to end the year for you guys for December. You know, this whole year is where life has been asking you to out with the old to make way for the new. Transformations have been taking place. For some people, it's really obvious. They can see the results in their physical world. They might have left a relationship, left a project they've been working on for a while, or changed roles at work, or, you know, moved house, or just whatever. Things that are pretty obvious in the physical world. Others, no. Everything's the same in their physical world, but they might be feeling a bit different from within. There may have been things that have happened this year, things that have unfolded that have caused you to view through different eyes. You may be feeling a bit more compassionate, a bit more wiser, a bit more understanding, a bit more tolerant, you know, a bit more community orientated. Everybody's different. Everyone's going to experience their 9 year differently. But you are at the end of this year to not be the same person. And that will continue on for next year too, because you are in a 1 year next year. And that is a year of new beginnings and new opportunities. Okay. And so what I want you to continue doing for the rest of the year as a 9 is look at, what have I outgrown? What's not working for me anymore? For some of you, it may just be a bad habit, a mindset, a person, a project you've grown out of, or a hobby. Others, it's just different. You know, everybody's different. It could be cutting down on drinking. It could be cutting down on sugar. It could be getting more exercise, you know. But know that whatever makes you feel good, do more of that. And that's a big theme for you for December. You know, there is a lot of opportunity for a lot of fun, a lot of excitement, a lot of socializing, a lot of adventure this month. So you want to take advantage of that energy. Do more of what makes you feel good, and not just because it feels good, but because in terms of the law of attraction and in terms of improving yourself and your life circumstances and attracting more synchronicity in your life, which is being in the right place at the right time, in order to do that, we need to do what's called raise our energy vibration. And how we do that is through our thoughts and our emotions. So if we deliberately think positively, and if we deliberately do more of what makes us feel good, then we're raising our vibration and we are meeting the universe halfway. We are inviting more synchronicity in our life so we can be at the right place at the right time. We can improve our health and we can attract more opportunities, favorable opportunities, and it's in our best interest to do just that. Great night. I also want you guys in this combination to say what needs to be said. If there are conversations that need to be said, things that need to get off your chest, things to clear the air, you need to be doing that with people. All right, so have as much fun as you can. I'll leave that with you, everybody. I wish you a fantastic Christmas for those that celebrate Christmas. And I am here if anyone needs me. There's my website up there, www.michellebuchanan.co.nz. Contact me if you need a reading. I'm doing my 2-for-1 reports, buy one software report or chart of your numerology chart and a 12-month forecast. I'll send it to you and then I'll ask for the details of the free second report. And they're $25, and that's about it, really. So just have a wonderful remainder of the year, and I'll be here to give you your forecast on the 1st of January. All right, take care, and thanks for your time. See ya.